The WWC reports on findings from studies that meet the eligibility requirements specified in the review protocol and that meet WWC design standards with or without reservations. Often, studies will report multiple findings, sometimes for the same outcome measure on different samples, or for multiple outcomes within a single outcome domain. The WWC follows procedures for reporting on findings from these studies. Additionally, the WWC summarizes the design, features, and samples of each study to provide important context for the findings. In most products, the WWC reports on all eligible findings that meet WWC design standards with or without reservations. Studies sometimes include multiple analyses of the same outcome measure. For example, the outcome could have been measured at different points in time for different samples or using different measurement approaches. In these cases, the WWC must determine which findings will contribute to its summary of the study or intervention's evidence. Among those eligible findings that meet WWC design standards, the WWC designates one or more findings reported in the study as the main findings that contribute to the WWC's summary of the evidence. Findings that do not contribute to the main summary are considered supplemental and might be reported separately, such as in an appendix. The WWC follows a set of guidelines when distinguishing main from supplemental findings. When a study measures the effectiveness of an intervention at multiple points in time, such as immediately after the intervention concludes and again later, the WWC chooses one point in time for the main finding. For example, a review protocol in a topic area where effects can take time to observe might specify that the latest follow-up is preferred. The WWC applies a more general rule to studies that report both a full sample finding and findings for one or more subgroups within the full sample. Subgroups might be defined by location, cohort, or student characteristics like gender or race and ethnicity. In this case, the WWC considers the full sample finding to be the main finding. The subgroup findings are reported in supplemental tables. If the study does not report a full sample finding, but two or more subgroup findings meet WWC design standards, the WWC will aggregate the findings into a single finding for the outcome measure using a weighted average. The formula for the weighted average is provided in the procedures handbook. When a study reports both the effect of the intervention on a composite score and on one or more subscale scores used to calculate the composite score, the WWC considers the finding based on the composite score to be the main finding, and the subscale findings are reported in supplemental tables. Remember, the WWC always determines the main findings in a study from among those that are eligible according to the criteria in the review protocol, and those that meet WWC design standards. For example, if the full sample finding in a study does not meet WWC design standards, but a subgroup finding does, then the subgroup finding is the main finding in the study and contributes to the WWC's summary of the evidence. These rules allow the WWC to characterize a study's findings based on the most comprehensive information available. However, not all studies will report a single finding or set of findings that reflect the full sample for the composite outcome measure and preferred time period. Sometimes, incomplete information about findings, overlapping samples, or other problems complicate applying the rules to a study or set of studies. In such cases, the review team leadership identifies main and supplemental findings in a way that best balances the goals of comprehensively characterizing each study's findings and presenting the findings in a clear and straightforward manner. Some WWC review efforts are designated as expedited by IES. For expedited reviews, the review team leadership also has discretion to focus each study review on eligible findings only from the full sample, rather than on subgroups, only using composite measures, rather than subscales, only using the most relevant time period as specified in the applicable review protocol, and only using the most relevant comparison group. Other eligible findings within a study may not be reviewed when the WWC conducts an expedited review. When using WWC design standards to review a study, the WWC gives each eligible finding in the study a rating and assigns a rating for the full study. Different contrasts within the same study may receive different ratings, such as when a full sample finding meets WWC group design standards without reservations, but a subgroup finding in the same study has high attrition and meets WWC group design standards with reservations. The study receives the highest rating among all the ratings given to eligible findings. So, for example, if any finding in a study, whether main or supplementary, meets WWC group design standards without reservations, the study as a whole will also receive that rating, even if another finding in the study is rated meets WWC group design standards with reservations or does not meet WWC group design standards. Within each outcome domain, the WWC characterizes main study findings across outcome measures. The WWC assigns one of three possible characterization labels to a domain based on the direction, magnitude, and statistical significance of the findings. These labels are statistically significant positive effects, indeterminate effects, and statistically significant negative effects. The criteria for characterizing findings depend on whether the domain includes main findings from one or more outcome measures. If a domain has a single outcome measure, then the main finding for that outcome measure determines the characterization. If there are main findings from multiple outcome measures in a domain, the WWC will base its characterization on one or more of the following three sets of information about the findings: the individual effect sizes and the number of findings that are individually statistically significant, the WWC aggregated main finding, and a WWC calculated measure of their statistical significance as a group, or a study-reported omnibus test, which is a single test that combines the outcome measures. Now, let's look more closely at the criteria for each of these study-level characterizations of findings. When an outcome domain includes a main finding from only one outcome measure, the WWC designates the finding as a statistically significant positive effect if the effect size is positive and statistically significant. When an outcome domain includes findings from multiple outcome measures, the outcome domain receives a characterization of statistically significant positive effects if it meets one or more of three criteria. The first way is based on the individual effect sizes and the number of findings that are individually statistically significant. At least one finding must be positive and statistically significant, and none can be negative and statistically significant. The measure of statistical significance must include any adjustments required by the WWC, discussed later in this module. The second way is based on the WWC aggregated effect size and statistical significance of the aggregate. The measure of statistical significance must also include any adjustments required by the WWC, discussed later in this module. These calculations must result in a positive and statistically significant average effect size. The individual findings have no direct role in the characterization based on this second criterion. The third way is based on the findings from a study-reported omnibus test, if provided. Again, the finding must be statistically significant and positive. The WWC applies the same criteria to an outcome domain used to identify a statistically significant positive effect to identify those having a statistically significant negative effect, except that positive effect sizes are replaced by negative effect sizes. The WWC uses criteria similar to those for positive effects when characterizing negative effects for domain-level findings based on a single outcome measure or multiple outcome measures. when the main findings in a study outcome domain do not meet the criteria for either positive effects or negative effects, the WWC will characterize the findings as indeterminate. Returning to the Reading Recovery Intervention Report, the findings in the alphabetics domain for Schwartz, 2005, were characterized as statistically significant positive effects. The average effect size was 0.62 standard deviations, which is positive, and the WWC determined that this average effect size is statistically significant. The WWC also documents information about a study that will not affect that study's rating. The WWC documents the study setting, characteristics of the study sample, features of the intervention and comparison groups, including any implementation issues, and how the intervention and comparison groups were formed. In addition, the WWC documents certain common issues that can affect how to interpret a study finding, including non-participation, contamination, and lack of fidelity. Non-participation occurs when sample members assigned to the intervention group do not participate in the intervention. If not all sample members participated in the intervention, but those non-participants are still analyzed as part of the intervention group, the effectiveness finding may be smaller than the finding that might have been obtained had all intervention group members participated. Contamination occurs when sample members assigned to the comparison condition receive the intervention. This is sometimes referred to as crossover. If these sample members provide outcome data and are analyzed as comparison group members, contamination can lead to a smaller finding. Finally, lack of fidelity occurs when components of the intervention are not implemented. Variations in implementation are to be expected in studies of interventions because they take place in real-life settings and not necessarily under tightly controlled conditions monitored by researchers. If effective intervention components are omitted, findings might be smaller. If a study includes information related to any of these topics, reviewers document this information during the review, and it may be included as context when describing the study and its findings in a WWC product. The WWC documents this information, but it does not affect how the study is rated. However, if a key component of an intervention was not implemented, the study cannot be considered to provide a true test of the intervention of interest, and it may be ineligible for review.